Good evening. On a tense but so far non-violent day here in central London, we'll be bringing you up to date later with what's been happening on the bomb front. Also, during this edition of Reporting London, I'm going to try to broadcast with one of these sets, and the fact that I've never used one before will no doubt become all too clear. Now, what's illegal, fun to use, and has invaded London in a big way in the last 2 years? It turns you on, but something you turn on. Citizen band radio. If you have one of these sets, you can talk on the airwaves to other people with the same sort of equipment. Up to now, all CB transmission has been illegal, but thousands of CBers have been using AM waveband equipment. Next week, CB will be made legal, but only on the FM waveband. That's just one of the strange features of the world of citizens band radio that Alan Hargreaves has been exploring.
Yeah, Breaker 19, this here's a rubber duck. You got a copy on me, Big Ben? Come on. Yeah, 10-4, Big Ben, for sure, for sure. By golly, it's clean clear to Flagtown. Come on. Yeah, it's a big 10-4 there, Big Ben. Yeah, we definitely got the front door, good buddy. Mercy sakes alive, looks like we've got us a convoy.
Break a break, break a break. This is Reject, this is Reject. Request half-wave platter pass Idaho.
My dad!
I'm no alligator, I only need a little help.
Banker!
Anchor it, amigo. A-OK. I'll back off on it. Balls out. Half-wave platter plus Idaho plus cactus juice. 10-10.
Roger, 10-10.
This is The Eyeball, a restaurant devoted entirely to the strange world of citizens band radio. Here, they even order their meals from the tables by radio.
10-4, okay.
If you want prawn salad with onion rings, you order a home office special with big earrings. And the sea beers, or breakers as they call themselves, have weird call signs of their own.
Which one of this lot, Smokey Bear?
I'm Morning Glory.
How did you get it?
Well, I started off as Golden Lady, but everybody else had the same handle, so I decided to find something different. And I like the flowers, they're very pretty.
There are thousands of breakers in London now, and hundreds of breakers clubs. The craze took off here 2 years ago and rapidly became big business.
We do probably in the region of 10,000 aerials a week, and nearing a quarter of £1 million a month now. Mm-hmm. It is very big business.
Although it's been illegal up to now to import, install and use CB radios, it's never been illegal to import and sell the accessories. When CB became legal in America, the craze began to die out, and wholesalers here were able to get massive job lots cheaply. British manufacturers claim that they've been done out of millions because no one would risk making or importing the equipment until the government legalized CB. A lot of the equipment is manufactured in the Far East. Although the law has stated up till now that importing complete sets is illegal, earlier this year a loophole was found.
We found that a company in Blackpool have now bring in CB radios in component form. They bring them into the Isle of Man and they bring them from the Isle of Man into England. Because there's no customs there, there are no problems.
Ladybird, how are you?
I'm fine, thank you. Really fine.
Because AMCB will remain illegal, many breakers like this housewife refuse to be identified. CBers claim their ranks include policemen, doctors, firemen, even some MPs. And CBers claim they'll continue to operate on the illegal band.
OK, listen, we've got to go and do some housework, so we'll be closing this station down. Love to all the family, Rubber Plant and everyone else. Take care. We'll catch you soon.
How scared are you of being busted?
Very scared, not for the fact of the fine or losing my equipment, which I do value, but for the fact that I would be very scared to switch back on again, and then I would possibly lose contact with all of the friends that I have made on the radio.
This is Widowmaker, a computer operator called Chris. During his 2 years of CBing, he's made many friends. One of them was on his way to meet us when he was caught by the police. The news was broadcast.
Shellfish, have you heard? The bear got busted this morning.
I don't believe it. Who told you? What happened?
Well, we're running a sort of stretched convoy down towards London this morning at about 9 o'clock. He was behind me, he was just having a, you know, friendly little chat. All of a sudden he tells me he's got a jam sandwich about 3 cars behind him. And the guy put the light on and pulled him over, and that was it. It was the end of the transmission. I mean, it's going to be a little bit nasty. The last time I got done, I was in the cells for 4.5 hours.
How many arrests do the police make every year?
I think they got 467 convictions out of all. I mean, they are convictions, people they actually took to court. They're not the people that they tracked down, which, when you consider that there's got to be upwards of 1.5 to 2 million users in London alone, that's not a great percentage.
In fact, no one knows how many CBers there are. Only 9,000 sets were confiscated in the whole of Britain last year. Since all the sets in use are illegal and not licensed, not even the Home Office, the police or the customs can put a figure to them. Fozzie Bear was released after a few hours and the customs confiscated his set. We arranged to meet. Where? Outside a London CB shop.
You're Fozzie Bear and you just got busted. What are you going to do now?
I'm just about to cross over the road and buy a CB, another one.
Another CB?
Yeah.
Although you've just been busted?
Yeah.
Well, I think I'll come in with you while you buy it.
Okay.
Fozzie Bear, my man, how are you? Good to see you,
Hello, Norgrace.
How do you do?
You heard the bad news?
Yeah, man, Kentish Town.
Yeah, right.
Well, I think I got what you need here, man.
My boy.
Okay. Let's see this, baby.
TriStar.
Yeah.
First,
how
much
is this? Not in multi-mode, but 160 without VAT, okay? Or 190 with VAT.
And the 190 is the legal one?
Yeah.
I think the 160 is the one I want.
Okay.
Scenes like this take place daily. CBers who can now buy legal sets are addicted to the craze.
Right.
They say they'll continue to trade in and send on illegal sets. Doesn't the law deter them?
Mr. Fozzie Bear don't care, you know? So that's the story. So you can buy them legal or illegal, doesn't matter.
And you don't mind selling illegal stuff?
No, not really, no, not
at all. Is most of your stuff here sold that is illegal?
Let's say 7 out of 10 radios I sell are illegal.
When it goes legal, there's going to be a massive boom, the same as colour televisions. Everybody wants one. But this means that it'll be within everybody's reach, CB radio, £65 to £70 for a set. But after the initial boom of 27 FM, I'm sure that people are going to get fed up because there's going to be so many people on 27 FM that they're going to resort back to the AM.
So you're in the dreaded West End. Much traffic about, I expect there is. There usually is there.
Yeah, we got a great big convoy. Ain't she a beautiful sight? Come on and join our convoy. Ain't nothing but a getting our way. We're gonna grow this fucking convoy across the USA. Convoy.
You want to give me a 10-9 on that Big Ben? Negatory, Big Ben, you're still too close. Yeah, them hawks are starting to close up my sinuses. Mercy's sake, you better back off another 10.
So from next Monday, breakers will be allowed to transmit on the FM waveband. Although up to now, practically all of them have used AM. Alan Hargreaves asked the Home Office Minister, Timothy Raisin, why the government had insisted on legalising FM.
We decided to legalise FM because AM causes far too much interference. We're getting about 1,000 complaints a week. And I think really people have got to understand that it simply is not fair that old ladies, people who depend heavily on television, should have constant interruption on their sets. And our firm belief is that FM will produce perhaps a tenth of the interference that AM produces.
What will you do and how will you police CB users if many of them, as they say, will not buy FM legally but will go on using illegal AM sets?
Well, basically what will happen is that if interference is recorded, the interference service, backed by the police, will investigate the source of interference. And of course, if it is found to be AM, if it's found to be illegal interference, then the prosecution...
Well, in advance of next Monday, we got a temporary license, or in CB language, a glory card, to transmit on the FM waveband, of course. Alan Hargreaves is with our outside broadcast unit at the Big E Breakers Club in Tottenham in North London. And let's see if we can get hold of them now, using the call sign, incidentally, that he himself has chosen. Thames Reject, Thames Reject, this is Reporting London. Do you read me? Not a thing. Don't appear with dogs, children, or CB radios. Nevertheless, let us revert to steam television and go directly to Alan Hargreaves, to Thames Reject himself in Tottenham.
Okay, I take it. I take it from that that nothing happened, but I want to ask a few people what they thought. Morning Glory, are you going to actually now go FM and jettison your AM stuff?
I doubt it very much, no. I don't think it's worth it, in fact.
But you'll be breaking the law.
Yes, that's true. But I think the more people that stick to the original channels will eventually get things started.
OK. What about you, Widow? What are you going to do?
Well, I think the government have missed the boat, basically. They're going to have to do the same as what happened in Australia and the Netherlands. As Patrick Wall said, they're going to have to change the systems over. There's no two ways about it.
Doesn't it worry you? You're Angel Gabriel. Doesn't it worry you that you're accused of interfering with poor old Lady's television sets and you're just being selfish by using AM?
No, because you can't... Well, you don't really interfere with people's television sets if you're doing on... Well, if you're transmitting on the right frequency.
But the Home Office said that you are interfering. I mean, so is this going to make you go legal?
No, because on half a watch, you're not interfering. You can't interfere on half a watch.
OK, fine. Very briefly, I'd like to come to this gentleman here. You're called Cake Maker. You have a pacemaker, don't you?
Yes, right.
Are you worried that CB is going to interfere with your pacemaker?
That's not at all.
So you're going to stay with AM?
I'll stay with AM.
All right, fine. Right, there's one other person I have to ask a question for. Zulu, you are on AM at the moment. How do you feel about the FM?
Well, at the moment, the government are trying to keep us onto FM because of interference. But, yeah, you know, as from Monday, I can legally interfere with hospital bleeper systems and just wipe them out. You know,
what do you mean you can legally interfere? I thought the whole reason for FM was to get off.
FM on 27 megs will wipe out hospital bleeper systems. They should have given us AM in the first place.
Really?
Really.
OK, fine. Well, I'm afraid that that's it now, Dennis. I just have one thing to say to you, and that is, OK, Buffalo, don't take too many brown bottles or feed the bears tonight. And I'll see you back in Smoky Town.
Thank you, Thames Reject. My CB dictionary tells me that the CB for gobbledygook is gobbledygook. Anyway, last Thursday, the Liberal SDP Alliance scored its most significant victory so far...